In Revelations 7 and 8. The first thing is the sealing of the 144,000 Jewish witnesses. Gahipos ang langit sang gininstruksyonan sang Ginoo, antis ko balbalon ang duta. Markahi ang tanan nga mga tribes of Israel who will bear the gospel of the Lord to testify. 144,000 in all from Judah, the tribe of Judah, 12,000, Reuben, Gad, etc., etc. One tribe is missing. There is no tribe of Dan. Oh, that's another topic. We will discuss that. Otherwise, maglapaw ko karon sa chimpo ko, so I will not go into that thing. But that is the thing that the heavenly crowd began to see. And then, amuni ang nagpalupok after 30 minutes of silence. What was that? A great rushing sound. Revelation chapter 7 verse 9. For lo, a great multitude which no man could number out of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues stood before the throne. Take note, they are not under the altar. Before the throne, before the Lamb, clothed with white robes, with palms in their hands, and they crowded with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our God, sitting on the throne and to the Lamb. And all the angels stood around the throne, and the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell before the throne on their faces and worshiped, saying, amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might to be to our God forever and ever. Amen. All of a sudden, nagdinagsa ang mga tao sa langit. At tong 30 minutes, I have a theory. Theory ko lang eh. They were watching the angels of heaven gathering the elect from the four corners of the earth. From the south to the north, to the east, to the west. And they knew that a mighty throne would enter heaven in one sweep. What is this? I do not know about you. I believe this is the rapture. Are you following? This has got to be the rapture. Because before Revelation chapter 7, there was no great multitude seen from every tongue, tribe, and nation. None. Hold on to your seats because I am coming to a point. But hold on. What is this sight? How did they get here? Where did they come from? Why were they not seen by John before? Revelation 7 itself tells us the conversation in heaven. Because in verse 13 of Revelation 7, one of the elders answered, saying to me, who are those who are arrayed in white robes and from where do they come? And I said to him, sir, you know, meaning to say, sir, I do not know, but you know. And he said to me, these are the ones who came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and have whitened them in the blood of the Lamb. There they before the throne of God, and they serve him day and night in his temple, and sitting on the throne will dwell among them. They will not hunger anymore, nor thirst anymore, nor will the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb who is in the midst of the throne will feed them, will lead them to the fountains of and God will wipe away all tears from their eyes. That brings me to the suspicion that when they were on their way, they were crying. Why were they crying that when they landed in heaven, the Lord will wipe away tears from their eyes? This is just my theory, okay? Number one theory. They must have thought of those whom they have left behind. Relatives, brothers, sisters who did not believe the Lord Jesus Christ. Pag kinitanay ito, atuto ang kinabunsang pamilya de la Cruz, pamilya mo ni. Si mama diin. Si tuto diin. Si classmate diin. why will there be tears in their eyes when they land in heaven? Why will the Lord tell the people, I will wipe away all tears from their eyes? So, maybe another reason is because they came out of great tribulation. So, this is the first time that a great multitude from every tongue, tribe, and nation was seen in Revelation. In other words, these are the raptured saints in glory. This could only be the result of the rapture. Question. Hindi lang may nakita before Revelation 7, may nakita na daya? Nga kadamo man? Aha, bantayin nyo maayo. Revelations 5, 11 to 12, damo nakita nga angels and beasts and elders. Thousands upon thousands. Revelations chapter 5. Wala to sang every tongue, tribe, and nation. Wala pa. Sa Revelation chapter 5, wala pa. Ti ano to yung Revelation 6? Nga, the souls of those who were slain, were they not in heaven? Okay. Here is an interesting line. The fifth seal reveals the soul of those who have been slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held, but they were not before the throne. They were under the altar. And they were souls or spirits. They had no at to yung Revelation 7 niya, bodies gid to ya. That's why nga, sa kadako-dako nga sight, bilog na langit, 30 minutes, Ara na sila, kadamo-damo sila, mga Amerikano, mga Meksikano, mga Pilipino. So, under the altar means grace period, before the throne means judgment day. So, what is the point here? Okay, we are nearing the end of this presentation. The first time the great multitude of believers from every tongue, tribe, and nation was seen was after the sixth seal. Meaning, to me, I do not know to you, the Christians at least had to go through the first five seals before the rapture. Common sense following the natural outline of the book of Revelation. So, basahon mo to ang first seal, second seal, third seal, fourth seal, fifth seal. You begin to pray in your spirit, Lord, if it is your will that we go through this, army with the armor of God. Does that mean that the Christian has to go to the tribulation period? Begging the question. Gusto mo gin sabton nga daw ko, obvious naman, pero abi pa man ko. Does that mean that the Christian has to go through the tribulation period? Ang damo gin nga Christian niya, masabat, no, we are Christians, we are children of God, we must not go to the tribulation. They make it work by distinguishing between the pre-raptured saints, pre-trib raptured saints, and the one on the one hand, and the tribulation saints on the other hand. Sili nila, lain na yung saints to yung nag-go to tribulation, tribulation saints niya. Pero ang church niya, the body of Christ niya, wala na yung nagkatuyang sa tribulation niya, hindi pwede niya. Kaya amon niyo, si Jesus na lang matambag sa aton. Let us ask Jesus, Bossing, what do you say? Be ready for Jesus' answer. Matthew 24. For then, there will be great tribulation. Look at the verse, verse 21. For then, there will be great tribulation such as not been seen since the beginning of the world until this time, nor shall ever be. And unless those days were shortened, no flesh should be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days will be shortened. Who are the elect? Siling sang dispensationalist. Oh, the elect refers to Israel. Nga ang kaantay Israel gin sa aton. Nga ang Israelites lang yung mga Hudiyo lang yung pa. Kita ya, hindi tayo mag tanawon takon makasurvive na ang theory nga only for the Jews. Still, Jesus is the one we are asking. pag-humble niya sina, this is what he said after. Verse 29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from heaven. The powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven. And then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds with power and great glory. And he will send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. And they will gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Does this not sound like the rapture? If this is not the rapture, then what is it? What is another event that looks like this? Abe, tell me. Huh? If this is the rapture, and it is pretty quite obvious that this is the rapture, it is after the tribulation of those days. I am sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but unless there is somebody who can correct me, and I will be happy to submit and say, okay, I did not read the Bible correctly, but I have read it so many times and it is so clear. So now, what do we do? Because I can feel that your heart is somewhere down the floor already. We will lift it up by the grace of God before we end. We are sure to be around during the period of the five seals. I do not know about you, but ako ya, insettle ko na lang. Shoot, Lord. Five seals. Fire. Will we be around during the seventh trumpet? Most likely, but maybe not. Because the seven trumpet judgments are found in chapter 8, 9, but in chapter 7, there is already the great multitude in heaven. So maybe not. Will we still be around in the seven bowls? I hope not. If you want to stay around, I can give you my ticket, but is there a way of knowing so we can properly prepare? I believe we can know. One important key is the promise of the Lord that we are not appointed unto wrath. Dirita bawi-bawi unang ato nga mga naglusda nga mga balatyagon. Because the Lord said in 1 Thessalonians 5, speaking to the Apostle Paul, concerning the times and seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write to you, for you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night. For when they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they shall not escape. But you, brethren, are not in darkness, so that this day should overtake you as a thief. You are all sons of light and sons of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night. But let those who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and as a helmet the hope of salvation. For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amuni ang daumidyo nami. We are not appointed to wrath. Di ano na ang meaning sang we are not appointed to wrath? Sining sang aton nga dispensationalist, pre-trib friends, we will not pass through the tribulation period because we are not appointed to wrath. And the tribulation period is the wrath of God. Siling sa iban, hindi na amo nang but silingin na. It means that we will not go to hell because hell is the wrath of God. Siling sa iban, we will pass through the tribulation period but we will not suffer the wrath of God during the tribulation period. Which is which? We need to ask the question, when is the wrath of God come? When is it coming? Summarize ko lang. Revelation chapter 6 verses 12 to 17, during the sixth seal when it came, nagreklamo ang mga nagkalaigo ng mga survivors, fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb, for the great day of his wrath has come, who is able to stand? If this is the great day of his wrath, the sixth seal, and if we are not appointed unto wrath, are you following? So maybe we will not be around when the sixth seal comes. But the others may not agree. My question pa, the word saints still appear in Revelations 8. 11, 13, 14, 16, anak pa ng saints. Plus the words of Jesus that there will be great tribulation, but for the elect's sake, those days will be shortened. Siling sang iban, well, the popular view says that tribulation is a time of Jacob's trouble only. It's only for the Jews, but not for the Christians. We already said we do not agree with this. On the appearance of the word saints in Revelations 8 to 18, there is an interruption theory by John Shorey. Sister Rita gave me this book. I studied it. The interruption theory goes this way. Si Jesus kuno was telling John the proper sequence. Then the angel who stands beside Jesus telling John is so excited, he interrupts Jesus and gives details. Nga si Jesus tani, ga-move on na sa story, pero ga-apas ang angel. So, kung basahan mo, it is as if nga nagliwat. Nabalbala na itong kalibutan, nagbalbal naman liwat. Actually, amo lang to pero galing kay ang angel gadugang pagid sang detail. Okay? Okay? So, you request from Sister Rita this book if you want to find out. And according to the study of the same author, iyan niya study ha, he believes that the seal season is between the period 2012 to 2020. Iyan ang iyang theory. And he has reasons why he is proposing that. But here is another good pre-rough view. Lapit na lang ni matapos. Revelation 16. I heard a loud voice from the temple saying to the seven angels, go and pour out the bowls of the wrath of God on the earth. Iniya ang voice na gidya from the temple in heaven speaking to the angels, calling the bowl judgments as the wrath of God. This is my personal view. I believe we will not go through the bowl judgments because that is the wrath of God. And we are not appointed unto wrath. Ako, I will go by, I am not appointed unto wrath. The bowls of the wrath of God are mentioned in the Bible, Revelation 16. I believe that there is no point in causing us to go through the wrath of God, the bowl judgment. But I believe that there are contrary views. So now, what do we do in view of all this? Considering that we will almost surely go through the seal season, ako yan, sigurado ko sa seal season. 1 to 5. Basi, trumpet man, but hopefully not the 7 bowls. But ang seals, sigurado gid. Only conclusion, we better prepare. Ang Bible nagasilingid, very clear, 1 Peter chapter 4, therefore, since Christ suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves also with the same mind. Do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is going to try you as though some strange thing is happening to you, but rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's sufferings, that when His glory is revealed, you may also be glad with exceeding joy. I can find this resonating with the first 5 seals. When there will be famine, hunger, there is no peace in the world, and there are drums beating and things like that. Okay? So, arm yourselves with a readiness to suffer. Ti mamangkot ka. Ti, you mean to say, Brother Lindon, that the church is going to be judged? 1 Peter chapter 4. For the time has come for judgment to begin at. And if it begins with us first, what will be the end of those who do not obey the gospel of God? Therefore, let those who suffer according to the will of God